Hey everyone, welcome to my channel Lenovate. Today we will going to discuss the spinal cord reflexes, the major stretch reflex of the spinal cord that we will going to discuss in this video are the flexor reflex or the withdrawal reflex, and the second one is the cross extensor reflex. By the diagram you can see that there is a flexor reflex going on one side, while that of the cross extensor reflex going on the other side of the same spinal cord segment. Now, what is a flexor reflex and how this reflex occur? When there is a excitation from any painful stimulus or the nociceptor, there will be a impulse transmission from the sensory neuron towards the posterior root ganglia and then towards the brain. From the higher centers, the response is integrated and it is coming in the path of the motor neuron. While that of the motor or the efferent neuron in the gray matter of the spinal cord initiate a neuronal circuit. Here you can see there are multiple neurons going from a one single neuron, and this intermingling of the neurons are called as the neuronal circuit that is present in the flexor reflex. This neuronal circuit is a diverging circuit, that from one neuron there will be a divergence of many other neurons and the impulse will be transmitted from one neuron to many other neurons. While that you can see here, an impulse from the motor neuron is also transmitted to the opposite side of the spinal cord, and this is crossing the central canal. We will discuss later about this side. Here you can see then after the divergence of the impulse, this is transmitted from the way to the motor neuron. Then this motor neuron transmit impulse to two side of muscle. It will cause the excitation of the flexor muscles to cause the contraction of the hand or the leg from the painful stimulus, or it inhibit the extensor muscles or the antagonistic muscles of the flexor muscle. So here the inhibition is the reciprocal inhibition. Why this is reciprocal inhibition? Because in the reciprocal inhibition there is a inhibition of the antagonistic muscle. By the definition, the reciprocal inhibition is that when a stretch reflex excites one neuron, there will be a simultaneous inhibition of the antagonistic muscle. When one muscle is excited, there will be a simultaneous inhibition of the antagonistic muscle to prevent the inhibition or prevent the reciprocal contraction of the antagonistic muscle and to strengthen the stretch. So here when the excited stimulus is given to the flexor muscle, there will be a contraction of flexor muscle and there will be a withdrawal of the hand from that object. So that's why this flexor reflex is also called as the withdrawal reflex, because this flexor reflex is not particular to the hand or the leg. It's not particular to any limb, but it may can occur in any part of the body. So there will be no contraction of flexor or extensor. There will be a contraction of the muscles that are present there, that will be anti-gravity or any intercostal muscles. So that's why it's called as a withdrawal reflex, that is giving away from the painful stimulus. Now the another reflex, that is a cross extensor reflex, that is going away from the opposite side of the same spinal cord segment. Here you can see in the opposite side of spinal cord, the signal is coming from this divergent circuit of the flexor reflex. When the impulse passes and crosses the central canal, there will be a presence of a reverberating circuit in the gray horn of the spinal cord on the opposite side. The reverberating circuit is working in harmony, that in the way this reverberating circuit will cause multiple excitation of again and again the same stimulus. When this occurs, there will be a polysynaptic circuit present here, and when the reverberation of the same impulse that is coming from the flexor reflex is occurring, there will be a excitation of the extensor muscle and inhibition of the flexor muscle. There is an opposite thing occurring here, because This cross-extensor reflex is important in maintaining the equilibrium of the muscle stress reflex. That's why one muscle is flexed, so the antagonistic muscle will not flex, not extend. If that will be extending, there will be no contraction. That's why to cause the proper flexion of one muscle, there will be an inhibition of the antagonistic muscle. And when this occur in one hand or one limb, there will be a flexor reflex. There will be ultimately the cross extensor reflex in the other part of that limb. So this is a simultaneous contraction of the other part of the limb. So the circuits that are involved in the flexor and the extensor reflex are: in the flexor reflex, there is a presence of a divergence circuit that is important for the divergence of the impulse. The other circuit was the reciprocal inhibition circuit, that is the inhibition of the antagonistic muscle. And the third one is the after discharge circuit. The after discharge circuit that is shown here is when the stimulus is over, or the fatigue of the stimulus occur after the action potential, there will be after discharge, that is a prolongation of the impulse or the slow fatigue of the impulse. This after discharge is very important for remaining of the withdrawal from the painful stimulus. So these three circuits are present in the flexor reflex. In the extensor reflex, the circuits present are the polysynaptic circuit, that is also the reverberating circuit, that is a again and again stimulation of the same impulse. The other, the reciprocal inhibition, same that was present in the flexor reflex, that is the inhibition of the antagonistic muscle. And the third circuit that is present in the extensor is the same after discharge circuit. Here you can see the after discharge of the cross extensor reflex is greater than the flexor reflex, and there will be a duration of the stimulus smaller than the after discharge. The long after discharge is important to prevent the flexion and extension of the opposite limb. I hope you will be explained well. By these myograms and the diagrammatic view of the flexor reflex and a cross extensor reflex, we will be having the generalized view about the spinal cord reflexes. Thank you for watching our video.